Modeling population is a very interesting application of differential equations. Now, since you've taken a calculus course, you're probably already familiar with a certain population model, and you could call it the exponential growth model. If a population grows at a rate which is proportional to the size of the population itself, in other words, dp dt equals kp, then the result is exponential growth. Now, there's other population models which you may not be as familiar with. For instance, the second one that I've written down here is called the logistic equation, and it's actually a better model for population in applications than the exponential growth model. I've written down another guy here, dp dt equals kp squared, and I don't know a proper name for this one, but you could call it maybe like a blow-up model because population blows up in finite time in this particular model. Rather than derive each of these models individually, what I'll do now is discuss a general population model from which each of these equations can be derived, among others. So let's start with a population, let's call it P of t. Now for this population we have a certain birth rate, beta. Now the birth rate is the number of births per unit of population per unit of time. Now a unit of population could be anything from a single individual to 10,000 individuals to 20,000 bacteria, and a unit of time could be a second or a year or a decade. And similarly, we have a death rate, we call it delta. And in the same fashion, it is the number of deaths per unit of population per unit of time. Now, just to give you some sense of what these quantities might be, for example, you can look up the CDC data on the United States, and I found in 2009, there were 13.5 births per 1,000 individuals, and that was in a single year. So that would be beta if I was to choose the units accordingly. I should point out a very important thing about beta and delta. Beta and delta may depend on the population size or the time. There's nothing that restricts this model to have beta and delta be constant. And this is a pretty reasonable dependency because, for example, the birth rate may go down as the population increases because there could be something like a food restriction or overpopulation may make people less likely to have children. Now, to set up a model for the population, we ask ourselves the same question we usually do when we're trying to derive a differential equation, and that is, how does the dependent variable change when the independent variable changes? So the question would be, how much does p change in some small interval of time, delta t? We'll call that change delta p. Now, it's easy to see that delta p will simply be the number of units of population born in that small amount of time, delta t, minus the number of units of population that die in that small interval of time. And by the definitions of birth rate and death rate, beta and delta, the number of units of population born is beta times p times delta t, and the number that die is delta times p times delta t. And so delta p is the difference of those two quantities. Now, as we usually do when we want to turn a sort of small change argument into a derivative, we divide both sides by delta t and take the limit as delta t goes to zero. And the result is a differential equation, which is what I call the master population model, the model from which the other population models are derived. And that's dp dt equals beta minus delta p. And I'll remind you again that beta and delta here may depend on p or t. That's perfectly okay in this model. Now up here I've written briefly what beta and delta are in each of these models. In the exponential model, exponential growth, beta and delta are constants. For the logistic equation, delta is constant and beta decreases linearly with the population. Now for this blow-up model, delta is zero and beta is proportional to the population. Now, just because we can, I'd like to throw a little extra something into this model. Suppose we have a fish pond, and the population of fish in that pond is governed by the population model such as this that we've derived here. But I like to catch fish, and so every year I catch 100 fish out of that pond. Now my question is, how would I incorporate that into this model? Well, I can't incorporate it through a birth rate or a death rate, because I catch 100 fish every year, no matter what the population is, as long as there's enough in the pond. And so it's not part of the birth rate or the death rate. And so all included is what's called a harvesting rate. And so the harvesting doesn't depend on the population here. It's just some harvest rate times the interval of time. So if I add this harvest rate, minus h delta t, into the change in population, delta p, then that gives me an extra h term on the right-hand side of the population model. dp dt equals beta minus delta p minus h. So this is the master population model with this little bonus term of harvesting to describe a constant draw on the population, such as fishing. And we could also describe a constant add to the population, like a certain number of immigrants who are allowed into a country, or a certain number of fish who are put into a pond in order to stock it.